Welcome to Getting Started with Panopto. Upon successful completion of this tutorial, you will be able to locate and enable Panopto within your Canvas course, choose the correct settings to record successfully in Panopto within Canvas, and record video and audio with Panopto, including primary and/or secondary sources. You will also be able to review and save your recording. How to locate Panopto in or add it to your Canvas course. Choose the course. Look at the course navigation menu. Does Panopto appear? If so, you're ready to go. If not, choose Settings from the bottom of the navigation menu and then go to the Navigation tab. Scroll down to the second set of items, locate Panopto, click the three dots to the right, and select Enable. Then choose Save at the bottom of the page. Working with Panopto. Click on Panopto Recordings in the course navigation menu. Click the Create button and choose Panopto for Windows. If you have not yet downloaded Panopto to your computer, do so now. If you're using a TWU computer, you might need the service desk to help you install. Once you have it downloaded, you can choose Open Panopto. Click Open Panopto Recorder in the second pop-up. The Panopto screen. The record button is fairly self-explanatory, but we'll come back to that. Let's begin with Session Settings to the right of the record button. Folder. Typically, this has your course name. If you click the drop arrow, you'll get a screen with choices of other courses, and at the very bottom right, the option to create a new folder. You can organize your recordings into a folder now or move it later. Name. This is the name of the recording you're about to make. By default, your video will be labeled with the current date and time. You can rename the video now or change it later. There is also a webcast checkbox. If you're presenting and recording in real time, this is the box to check. If your webcam is in place and working, you will see your face here to the left. Above your face, you'll see the label Primary Sources. Your face is considered the primary stream or primary source. If your webcam is not working, not connected, or you don't have a webcam, you will see a microphone information at the top instead, like this. Below your face, you will see options. Video. How are you recording the video? Webcam is pretty standard and can either be a separate piece of equipment that's at the top of your computer monitor or built into your laptop or tablet. If you don't want to record your face, you can set the video to none using the drop arrow at the right. Next is audio. What is the source of the audio input? Your microphone may be built into the webcam, part of your laptop or tablet, a separate headset, such as the one I'm using, or a standalone microphone. The drop arrow next to audio allows you to choose your input. If you talk right now, you should see the boxes to the right of your face light up. You want your normal speaking volume to register with the green flashing bars, and 4 to 6 bars is optimal. Higher or lower is fine as long as you stay in the green range. If you are up in the yellow or the red range, you may have sound issues later. So speak and adjust using this blue dot slider. Try to place it in the green range. Background noise may be an issue, but if you're recording in a fairly quiet room, you should not see flashing here except when you speak or make a noise. You do need a working audio device. When you replay your test videos, you'll be able to assess whether your audio device meets your standards. Next is quality. What quality do we want to record in? It's a good idea to choose the best quality we can get with the connection we have. We suggest you choose high. You may choose ultra if you are absolutely certain you have the connection and bandwidth to support it. Capture computer audio is a checkbox. Will you be showing anything during your recording that has its own sound source? Are you showing a video clip, playing an audio recording, background music, etc. within your presentation? If so, check this box. If not, this can remain unchecked. Below the video audio quality choices, you will see secondary sources. You can have 1, 2, 3, or no secondary sources. The secondary sources include what you'll be showing in your video. Typical sources are PowerPoint and or something on your desktop, which is called main screen, such as a document, chart, image, web page, another video clip, etc. If you have a two monitor setup on your computer and will be using both screens, you can choose Capture Second Screen. Whatever secondary sources you choose will appear as tabs at the top of this big square to the right. To get a preview of your selections, check the box at bottom left of the black screen that says Enable Screen Capture Preview. Note that Main Screen View will show exactly what is active on your display at the moment. Right now, since that is likely the Panopto player, you will probably see a tunnel, a picture of your screen within another picture of your screen, and so on. Don't worry about that for now, because once you start recording, you will display your PowerPoint or minimize this screen to show other material. Below the Enable Screen Capture Preview checkbox, you will see resolution options. The value in the first box will differ based on your computer settings. This is the screen resolution. You typically want this to match your desktop resolution, and it will show that by default. The second option is labeled FPS. This is frame rate in frames per second. You should adjust the slider to show 10 to 15 if your video is just your face and a PowerPoint, document, spreadsheet, etc. If you will be showing other video clips within your video, slide it to about 20 to 30 so it won't be choppy. On my computer, the options for FPS jump 4, 8, 15, 24, 25, 30. So I choose 15 for still images and 24 or 30 for video within video. The third option is kbps, which is bitrate in kilobytes per second. We want this to be at least 1,000, so use the slider. I'm going to choose 1,500. Now you're ready to record. See the red record button? Hit that, wait for the time to start ticking, and talk a bit. My name is Denise. I'm creating a video. When you're done, you can choose Stop, or you can choose Pause. This allows you to continue recording after a break. This pause feature is something you may use quite often when you're really recording lectures. When you hit the Stop button, you will see a pop-up that says Recording Complete. You will also see the session name below the green check mark. If you named your recording at the start, it will show here. If you did not name it, you'll see date and time information. You can also rename the video now if you'd like. The box also shows the folder where the video will be stored and a place to enter a description of the recording, which is optional. At the bottom, you get the options Delete and Record Again or Done. If you choose Delete, it will ask if you're sure. If you choose Done, you'll be taken to a list of your videos. The most recent video will be Processing. You will be able to choose Resume to go back to the Panopto screen and continue recording the same video, or Share to link or embed in a course or designate who can access the video. Soon, the Edit option will be clickable, and when processing is complete, the View option is available. There are two blue buttons next to each video session. Delete Local removes the video from your computer, but if you were online while recording, the recording remains in the Panopto cloud. Set Offline is used if you were offline when recording and want to upload the video to the Panopto server when you are online again. You can also delete an offline recording with this button. Click the black button at top left that says Create New Recording so we can revisit the main Panopto screen. Adding your PowerPoint. Preferred method is to open the PowerPoint on your computer outside of Canvas and Panopto. You will run the PowerPoint using Capture Main or Second Screen. And make sure to uncheck Capture PowerPoint. This is the simpler option as it can provide you more flexibility. This can be especially useful if you're picking up from where you left off in a previous lecture, or if you'll be going in and out of the PowerPoint while viewing other sources. Once you have your PowerPoint selected, you can begin recording. Choose the Record button, then minimize this Panopto screen using the line at upper right of your screen. Then maximize and begin your PowerPoint. When you're done recording, click the Panopto icon in the toolbar at the bottom, which is a green hexagon, to bring up the Panopto window, and click Pause or Stop to stop the recording. Save it, and wait a few minutes for the recording to process. Once you see the Edit and View buttons appear, you will be able to play back your recording. You can view the video from here or through the Panopto Recordings button in your course. For now, let's close the Panopto window. Working with recorded videos. Recording your videos within Canvas using the Panopto player, your videos will all be available to you using the Panopto Recordings button in your Canvas course. Having them in one location allows you to embed or link them from multiple locations. Click the Panopto Recordings button in your course to see all the videos you've recorded thus far. You can sort by name, duration, or date using Sort By above your list of recordings. To play the video, you can select the title of the video or click on the video thumbnail. Notice when you hover over recording with your cursor, you will see several options appear. Choose Delete only if you're sure you don't want the video to appear in the list. We'll go through how to use these other options in Part 2 of the Panopto tutorial. This concludes Getting Started with Panopto, Part 1.